hello, hello, everyone. Today, I unfortunately don't have an intro for you, but I have these lovely pictures. If you want to know how to do this look, then stay tuned. We're about to get started. Just to begin, I'm going to take this headband, put this in my hair to remove my hair out of my face. Just to let you guys know, I went ahead and put on a little bit of Chanel's Tint Innocence in Beige 40 and a little bit of strobe cream from MAC, and I mixed these two together and I put that all over my face. Then I dusted over with a kabuki brush a little bit of the pressed mineral powder from Laura Mercier. I just used Rich Vanilla as the color on my face. And then I went ahead and put on a little bit of Bobbi Brown Corrector in light to medium bisque and the Bobbi Brown Creamy Concealer in sand all underneath my eyes. I patted on the pale yellow powder underneath to set that. And I also went ahead and filled in my brows. I just use MAC's Charcoal Brown, which is just a really pretty brown, to give my brows a little definition. I'm going to be taking a little bit of the Laura Mercier Eye Basics in cotton, and I'm going to smooth this all over my eyes. Just so you can see a little better, I zoomed you in, and I'm just going to take this and smooth this all over my eye using my middle finger. Just want to get a nice coat on my eye. This is just going to even out the skin tone and make it easier to apply the shadow. Jennifer Nettles has a very light eye in this look, so I don't want to go too heavy on the eye because the eyeliner is statement enough. I'm going to be taking a little bit of the Naked Pigment, and I'm just going to put a little bit of this in my palette, and I'm going to tap a little bit on a 239 brush. I'm just going to tap this right on the eye. And it's going to look a little sloppy right now, but don't worry, I'm going to blend it through. I'm just going to blend out any harsh edges I have with a 224 brush, and just going to blend it all the way up because this color is kind of my all-over color. It has a little bit of shimmer, it's really pretty. I'm next going to be taking Omega from MAC, and I'm just going to tap this on that 224 brush as well and blend that ever so slightly through this crease. I just want to add a little bit of depth to the eye. Just take that rice paper on a 232 brush, bring that right under the eyebrow, blend it down into that nice Omega color you put down. Just really want this to define the brow. I'm going to be using the Penultimate Rapid Black Eyeliner. It's just an eyeliner from MAC, and it's liquid, and you can use any black liquid liner you have. And I'm just going to run this along the lash line, the top of my eye, and really make it heavy and dramatic like Jennifer Nettles. Bring that flick out. She has quite a dramatic eye, so you really want it to be dark, dramatic, and heavy. You want it to be very clear that you are wearing black eyeliner. So your eye should look something like this, very heavy black eyeliner. And Jennifer Nettles actually has her eyeliner a little bit straighter. If you want to make yours straighter, you can definitely do that. I kind of like the cat eye to come up a little bit, so that's why I always do mine that way. If you would prefer a straighter eye, just don't bring it up so much at the ends. I'm going to be using Clinique's Gel Liner in Very Black, and I'm going to put this just on an angled brush, and I'm going to take this right from where that pinpoint liner ended, underneath the eyelashes. And hers goes quite far underneath the eyelashes. I'm going to go to about here on the eye. just going to take a white eyeliner. This is Fascinating Eye Kohl from MAC. I'm going to line inside the waterline. I'm going to be using some Sassy Fake Lashes. These are the number 505s. They're just really pretty. I'm going to go ahead and put these on, and then I'll be right back. So I just went ahead and put my eyelashes on, as you can see. So it's just a little bit of the band showing, so I'm just going to go over it a little bit with some black eyeliner. The white is actually the glue, which is still drying, so... And there we go. We have some nice, really fun fake lashes on. They are quite plush and fun. I'm going to put over some Smoky Lash Mascara in extra black, just to define them a little better. This bold eyeliner. Then I'm going to take a little bit of the same Smoky Lash and go right underneath the eye. Just get those bottom lashes nice and done. Jennifer Nettles has a nice little contour on her cheek. I'm just going to take a little bit of MAC Bronze and an angled, or a tapered brush rather, at f2.5, and just lightly contour. I don't want it to be too strong because her contour isn't too strong either in her look. It's quite soft and pretty, so I want mine to be the same. Just want to look healthy glow to my skin. One thing Jennifer Nettles is not skimping on in her music video for Stuck Like Glue, in the Sugarland video, is highlight. She definitely has a lot of highlight on her cheeks. I'm going to go ahead and copy that same sort of look by using NARS's Albatross, and I'm going to dust this on my cheeks purposely, right here on the cheeks, because she definitely has it right here, and across the cheekbones. I'm going to blend that out a little bit because I'm going to put down a cheek color. I just want that nice, pretty, shimmery base to be down first, since she has such a shimmery cheek going on as well. I'm then going to take a little bit of NARS's Torrid Blush, which also has a little bit of shimmer in it, and I'm going to dust that very lightly on the cheeks. Hers is quite light blush. Blend it out a lot so that it's kind of soft. Make sure it really goes into that albatross because you want them to be very shimmery, her cheeks. I'm going to be using a really soft nude color to line my lips. I'm going to zoom you guys in so you guys can see. This is just Ginger Root Cream Stick from MAC, and I'm going to be mixing two lip glosses together. This is Strange Potion from the Venomous Villain Collections, and this is Revealing from MAC. And these I'm just going to mix together to give a really soft nude lip. Now, before I do that really soft nude lip, I'm still going to add a little bit of Albatross to the top of my lip, and I'm going to blend it in a little better. Final Jennifer Nettles inspired look with her really strong eyeliner, really nude lip, and really shimmery cheek. And this is from the Sugarland Stuck Like Glue music video. And if you haven't seen it, you should check it out because that song is awesome. And although I'm not a big country music fan usually, I love Sugarland. I have every single album they've ever made, and I thought this look would just be really fun to recreate with the really fun, deep, dark eyeliner, the fake lashes, pretty nice nude, kind of shimmery lid, a really shimmery cheek, nice peachiness, and a nude lip. So I hope you guys all enjoyed this, and if you have any questions or comments, or if you want to see any other videos in the future, please let me know. Thanks guys, have a great day, bye!